Come on.
So on Sunday, Carlos Alvarado Quesada won the presidential election in Costa Rica. But it was his vice president, that lady, who made history.
Nice.
Economist and longtime politician Epsi Campbell Barr is the first Afro-Costa Rican to be elected to the office. She was named for her father's mother, who moved from Jamaica to Costa Rica.
That's right.
Where she was born. I'm trying to remember the province in Costa Rica where the Jamaicans went to. I will remember it. Some Jamaicans went there and they actually speak Patois. I've been there a couple of times and I was on a coaching course with a Costa Rican. Oh man, why can't I remember? Somebody does.
When they came to Jamaica during the World Cup, the guy who was translating for them was translating in Patois. And I remember saying to him, it's okay, you can speak natural, probably, you know, just regular English. And he said, I talk. Yeah. So he said, okay. So his English really is Patois.
Yeah.
But this is amazing. It's your Jamaica impact the world.
Why can't I remember it?
We just, our it's father's mother. So our grandmother moved to Costa Rica.
Oh, you mean, man?
So like a Jamaican DNA. Yeah.
Cadine is the greatest. Limon, I think it's.
Limon.
That's where the Jamaicans went. I quote, she says, it will be a responsibility not only to represent people of African descent, but to represent all women and men in the country, a country that gives us all the same opportunities.
Nice.
It would not be the first only in Costa Rica, but in Latin America. And eventually, if the president leaves the country, I would be the first woman of African descent to assume the presidency of the entire American continent. It's a big responsibility. There you go.
And there's a big discussion happening now where we're talking about Black Lives Matters in the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a big discussion happening in Latin American and Central American countries about who do we call Latin American, that people have a particular look and that the people of African descent get overlooked.
Yep.
So it's nice to see
her
there. Jamaica, please invite her to come for something.
To Smile Jamaica.
She's a daughter of the soil.
Smile Jamaica.
We want her here.
Right on Smile Jamaica.
Nice.
Commonwealth Games started yesterday and Jamaicans have done well already.
Nice.
The Sunshine Girls, well, that's Alia. She in the 50 meter breaststroke semis. She won her heat. Swimming out of lane 4, 30.17 seconds. It's the best time recorded in the history of the Commonwealth Games.
Yeah.
There you go.
And the netballers. Woo, wah, 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 wah.
No, that was 2014.
Oh.
That wasn't yesterday. That was 2014 she did the best time.
Oh.
She clocked 30.98 yesterday to advance as one of the 16 qualifiers to the second round. She was the fifth fastest among all qualifiers. She carried the flag at the opening ceremony.
Wasn't the rugby team supposed to be going
for the
Commonwealth
Game?
Okay.
Jamaica also won the netball 88-30 over Fiji. Fowler Reid, who is the captain of the female contingent, 40 of 43. Romelda Aitken, who went on in the third quarter, 24 from 32. Rebecca Robinson, 15 from 16, as Jamaica dominated the game all quarters. 22-29 in the first, 27-6, 22-9 in the first, 27-6 in the second, 27 in the third, and 19-8. So they're often winning. There you go. They will next face South Africa at 2 minutes after midnight tomorrow, Friday.
Yeah.
What's the next one?
Fake weed. Hospitalizations grow to 70, including 2 fatalities.
Wow.
70 cases of severe bleeding, including 2 deaths, linked with synthetic cannabinoids, often called spice, K2, or fake weed. And this is across the Chicago area and areas in central Illinois. State health officials reported 56 cases, including 2 deaths, were men in their 20s. 9 of those cases tested positive for Brodifacom or rat poison.
Oh.
Granny always tell with careful where you take from people. to ingest.
No, I don't
say
no
eat from people. No,
why
you're buying weed. There, it's legal, so I can say so. You're buying weed. You know where you're buying it from? This is something coming into your body.
But don't they know it's fake weed?
You know, look, sir. I don't know. I don't know if it's...
I mean, my people sniff all the glue and things because they want to get high.
Yeah.
So they probably know it. I hear say it. Then.
Well, he's saying synthetic marijuana, fake weed, human-made chemicals that can be either sprayed on dried, shredded plant material and smoked.
That's right. That's how they know.
There's no such thing as one synthetic cannabinoid. There's hundreds of them. In fact, and in the setting of this outbreak, when we've been interviewing our cases, we've heard dozens of names that these are going under. So just not take them.
Sure.
Not take them.
Whoa.
Don't take them. When Jamaica eventually catches up with the rest of the world and starts the industry, buy from Jamaica. Come to Jamaica and feel all high. That's a nice slogan.
With the Rastaman name, where they make police.
No, Rastpedla. But Rastpeds.
Yeah. No, Delia, man.
No, man.
Rastpedla have a picture on the front page of the newspaper.
So it's not me, then, Neville, who put it on the newspaper?
With the man Ganja.
Delia, now,
in her bright way, come on television and say, she don't understand how the authorities allow that. Well, you know, the next day, them lock up Rastpedla. Serious thing.
Peds.
The very next day, them lock up Raspedla.
Never know so me and Peds move on from there for a long time.
Raspedla, don't tell you where she live. You're going to have a little discussion with her. The very next day, police find the great Raspedla and lock him up.
Me and Peds move on a long time.
You're Peds.
Me and Peds. Peds, man in the air, Peds. Raspeds. You know
what? All right.
But no, you know, Jamaica, yeah. Why it takes so long to get things done? We complain, you know, we are struggling with our money, IMF, and this can help us to ease the economic burden.
Yep.
Somebody move. Well, Mas Adley gone to agriculture now, so maybe Mas Adley. Mas Adley is a man who will pass him things.
You probably want to give Raspedla number.
So Mas Adley, make me hear what happened.
All right, time for some birthdays. Happy 10th birthday to Annalie. Annalie, they don't give me a last name, but it's from your dad, Leroy, and your mom, Donna. And they say they love you, Annalie, and we love you too. So have a great day. Happy birthday, Kamisha Williams Smith. It's from Dad Leon and her brother Rashane. And happy birthday to Amanda Mingus. I hope I pronounce it right. And it's from Leon Williams. Hope you have a great day. What you have?
So it's Mr. Robinson's birthday. This is Mr. Robinson, otherwise called Rambo or Robbie, from Vauxhall High School. Mm-hmm. It's coming from Stacey Ann Mills, from Marlene. And of course, your daughter Jolene, who is overseas. Morning, Rambo. Happy birthday to you. Enjoy the day.
Happy birthday, folks.